Hi guys, a very warm welcome from Archipi Creations. I would like to welcome you to our new course on Sora Art. First of all, let me thank you all for your continued appreciation of our work. Do continue to watch our videos, like our videos, subscribe to them. Also press the bell button so that you can be notified as soon as we are coming up with a new course or are going live. Do also tell your friends and family so that we can spread the word around. Now let me tell you a little bit about Archipi Creations. At Archipi Creations, it is our endeavor to spread art and craft. And we keep doing various kinds of series on different forms of art like Valli, Madhubani, calligraphy. Madhubani calligraphy also we've covered. Mandala, dot mandala is what we've just gotten over with. And other than that, we've done kalamkari, patachitra, clay modeling and various other forms of crafts as well. So do dive into the channel and do look out for your favorite playlist and do let me know which is your favorite topics that we can also cover in the future. Now in the later part of this video, we will be discussing what all will be the material that you need for Sora Art. But before that, let us quickly delve into the history of Sora Art, what it is, how it was done and how it is transforming in the modern times. After which we will discuss the various materials that you need for the course. So let us quickly start.
So now let us discuss about Sora Art. First, what is Sora Art? Now Sora tribal art is a form of art which is originated from eastern part of India. And it was mainly a kind of wall art that was practiced by the Sora tribal people belonging to Orissa. Now these paintings are known as icons and are of religious significance. They have a lot of religious significance. These were previously done in the walls of the houses, but now you can see Sora art being done everywhere in India and on various modes and bases. Now what is depicted in Sora art? It is mainly related to the history, to the philosophy and to the religious beliefs of the people. Let us learn a little more about the history of Sora art. So here we will learn about the Sora tribe. Now Sora tribe is one of the oldest tribal communities in India. The details of these tribes are mentioned both in the Ramayana and the Mahabharata. It is believed that Mata Shabri of Ramayana and Zara the hunter who had wounded Lord Krishna by his arrow both belonged to the Sora tribe. That is the reason why Sora tribe, in Sora tribe there is a lot of importance of Hindu epics and it is a great center of importance especially for on religious ceremonies in the district of Orissa. Now let us learn how were the Sora art paintings made. So what was the base? For the Sora art paintings, the base was reddish, brownish, blackish walls of the houses of the villagers of the Sora tribe. What were the colors used? Mainly the colors that were used were natural colors and natural dyes. And these natural dyes were made from natural ingredients like rice, white stone, flowers, flower extracts, leaf extracts, etc. What was a brush? So in this case, tender bamboo sticks were taken and they were used as a brush to create those super beautiful paintings. Now the paintings mainly depicted the religious deities of the Sora like the Idithal and they were mainly done on good occasions like festivals, marriages, childbirth, harvest, etc. Now in Sora paintings, there are icons which are very important and generally nature plays a very very important role. So you will see the presence of a lot of nature elements like rivers, like trees, water, sun was very important again in Sora paintings. All of these have their meanings and symbolism. Now who made these paintings? In the ancient times, only the priests of the Sora tribe made the paintings. And after they made the paintings, they would explain the detailed meanings of the paintings to all the other people of the community. Now what is Sora art today? Though Sora art is a reflection of our cultural practices, history and religious beliefs, it has evolved as a commercial form of art. So now you can see Sora art everywhere. But this art form still reflects the ethos of being nature lovers, and nature plays a very significant role even in your Sora art paintings that you'll see today. Now, today's Sora art paintings have got modernized. They have come out from the walls of the houses of the Sora tribe people and are now seen on clothes, like you will see them on saris, cushion covers, tablecloths, table runners. You will also see them on purses and clutches. They are made into paintings that we'll be learning. They are also done into lampshades or other forms of artifacts. So in this way, Sora art has modernized, and let us also learn Sora art in detail. So now let me discuss what all material you will need to do this particular course. Now that we've learned about the history of Sora art, let us learn about what all materials we will need for this particular course or series. For this particular course, I will be making 4 smaller size paintings, and these I will be making on a black base. So I have taken a half of an A4 size black sheet. We will need 4 of these sheets. So though I'm doing them on a black base, you can decide to do them on any colored base. Black looks really pretty, so we'll be doing it on a black base. I will be using my white pen. So for this purpose, I am using a Uniball Signo 0.7 white pen, which we'll be using for our black sheets. So these will be the first 4 projects where we learn the various elements of Sora art. But in this course, we will be learning them with the medium of creating 4 different paintings in our first 4 courses, followed by another big painting. So for the last or the 5th lesson of the series, I will be using a watercolor sheet. Now, if I have to show you the cover of the watercolor sheet, this is a Brasto Artist watercolor sheet, A4 size. You can also use any other sheet which is 300 GSM or more for the purpose of creating the final project. For that, I'll be using my black pens. So you can either use a black gel pen, which is waterproof and fade proof. You can also go in for using a Micron or a Brasto or a Unipin. Any of these are good waterproof brands. Any of these pens are fine. And you can use any colors of your choice. Here I'll be using my brush pens. You can use your sketch pens, poster colors, acrylic colors, watercolors, any colors which you have with you, just grab them. So this is what we'll be needing for our final project. So quickly grab your materials and we are all set.
Do like our video and subscribe to our channel. And don't forget to press the notification button so that you can be notified as soon as we put a new video or are live on our channel. Thanks for watching and bye-bye.